My name is Dr. Bryant Marks. I'm a professor of psychology at Morehouse College in Atlanta, Georgia, and also chief equity officer at the National Training Institute on Race and Equity. When it comes to the employee life cycle and the role of implicit bias can play out in four different phases. What do I mean? There's hiring, there's talent development, there's promotion, and there's the exit. Let's talk about the hiring process and what's involved. Oftentimes when we hire someone, the resumes come in, whether it's online or paper, and we take a look at the resume to determine who's going to be interviewed. What the science says is that implicit bias can play out at the resume level. What do I mean? When you look at a resume, there's a lot of information there, including the person's name. What the science says is that somebody's name on the resume could increase or decrease the likelihood of them being called in for an interview. A study came out, it was done in Boston and Chicago a few years ago, where they had names on the resumes, right? All the resumes were equivalent in terms of experience, qualifications, and education, right? And these resumes were submitted online. Now, half of the resumes had mainstream sounding names, right? Allison Johnson, Michael Jones, right? Others had more ethnic sounding names, Malik Johnson or Aisha Jones, that sort of thing. What they found is that those are the ethnic sounding names, Malik and Aisha, 30% less likely to be called in for an interview. Now, keep in mind, their resumes were literally identical. How do you explain that? What the science says is that when we hear somebody's name, it activates a certain set of traits associated with that name. And for some people, whether they know it or not, their names can literally undermine their ability to get a job. What do I mean? There are tens of thousands of people right now in society, in the United States and all around the world, where they are at a systematic disadvantage in terms of getting a job based upon a characteristic over which they had zero control, their name. How many of y'all actually named yourselves? Exactly. They didn't either. So here's the deal. As a manager, what you can do to try to address name bias on resumes, you could have a process, a practice, a policy, where when resumes come in, you simply take the name off. Why do you need to see somebody's name on a resume? Show me the data that says in your organization, knowing somebody's name has led to a better choice or longevity or better performance, right? Show me the actual data. Don't assume, don't tell me what you believe or what you think. Do you actually have the data that says this person's name is more likely to lead to a successful employee? Exactly. Most organizations don't have that name, so why do you need to see it? Why do you need to see somebody's address on a resume? For what? Right? What is the upside of that? If anything, it's neutral or it can cause some bias depending on where they live and how you perceive their neighborhood. So the notion is this. When you think about a resume and how you're going to vet somebody to be called in for an interview, really look at your position. What are the characteristics, qualifications, and education needed for that position? And then look at the resume. If there's categories on the resume that's irrelevant, simply take it off. Or at least come up with some justification for keeping it. If you want to know what school they went to, do you really need to know the specific school? Or do you need to know they went to an accredited four-year institution and they have a bachelor's degree? Unless you believe some schools are better than others. Why not categorize the schools? You don't think, be honest, if somebody went to the same school you went to, if you went to college, you don't think there's a little bit of a connection, a little bit of bias may kick in? So if you want to know the caliber of school, create categories or tiers and have HR put those schools into tiers. So there's different ways you can do this, still having some more detailed level of information that may avoid your biases kicking in. What's in a name? Apparently more than we thought.